We're looking at repair and pay-per-use. Can you tell us about your business model and what does HOMI offer and what is the meaning of pay-per-use?
Mm-hmm. So HOMI is a company that focuses on making the home appliances industry, the white goods industry, more sustainable, more circular, because we believe that actually that industry has been sort of lagging behind when it comes to sort of changes that actually help to make these machines last longer, use less resources. And where HOMI comes in is what we try to do. We focus on changing both the machine and making that more durable, but also looking at how the machine is used and focusing on sustainable use of the machine. So HOMI offers a pay-per-use concept, which means that people don't actually buy the machine anymore. Okay. They get it for free. We can come in and install it, repair it if necessary. And then they literally pay, in this case with the washing machine, per wash. And with that, we try to make sure that people are more aware of when they use and how they use the machine. And for example, by changing the pricing based on the temperature of the washing, which is the biggest leading factor when it comes to the electricity and the energy usage of the machine, we try to steer them in the right direction by, for example, giving them a lower price for a 30-degree wash and a more expensive price for a 90-degree wash. So that's the focus, both on the sustainable aspect for the consumer side and in the long term, also focusing on machines and making those more durable and more sustainable.
Well, so HOMI is an example of a company focused on providing services instead of products. So you said, you know, it's the service that you're offering. You're not asking somebody to buy washing machines.
Correct.
Well, that's interesting. And you've also said that HOMI, you try and ensure that people are using less energy, which of course is good for them, but it's also good for the planet in terms of pollution and emissions and so on and so forth. But there's also something around materials then, I guess, that you're saving on materials. How does that work?
Absolutely. Well, we see right now that every year about 50 megatons of e-waste, as they call it, so waste from these kind of machines, think about fridges, dryers, dishwashers and so on, is being thrown out. There's huge piles in China and Africa of just waste of these kind of machines
and
being
Europe.
Thrown out. And Europe. Yeah, it's often coming from Europe and the States. Yeah. And that number is actually growing every year. We see it's about a 5% increase every year. That means that a lot of resources are being wasted in this method, and that's understandable in a way, because OEM, so the producers of these machines, they only make money when they sell you a new one. So they would like to actually have one break down every 5 years, because that means they can actually sell you another. Now, changing the business model to a service model will help to actually focus on the right thing, actually on focusing on lengthening the life of a appliance like a washing machine. And because if you do that, the appliance owner or the manufacturer in some cases will have a benefit of having building a machine in such a way that it can last longer. So on the one hand, durability is an important thing, but also repairability. So making a machine, rather than actually what it has been in the last couple of years, more difficult to repair, making it easier to repair, or even easier to take out certain parts and put in new components and update and upgrade whilst actually keeping most of the rest of the machine. So not throwing out too many resources.
I get it. Yeah, okay. So your current focus seems to be on, you talked about repair there, on sort of professionals repairing the machines. Do you think the customer should be able to do that themselves in the future? Would that be an option, and how might that work?
To me, that is the ideal future. I believe that actually these kind of repairs should be so easy that actually a person can just literally take out one component that is either degraded, too old or broken down, and easily replace it with a new, maybe updated version of that part of the product. So maybe only just replace the engine. And it would, as a company, save me a lot of money if I don't actually have to send an expensive, trained engineer to your house. But actually, if I can just send you something by post and you just put that part in, that's easy for you because you can easily do it, hopefully with the right design. And it saves me time and money in order to make those kind of repairs.
Might that be then that you would have a relationship with the manufacturer of the machine?
Absolutely. If we look at the future for us, we first are trying to first prove that the pay-per-use concept has an impact. We can now see that about 25% of your water and electricity usage goes down because of pay-per-use. So we're already succeeding in the usage part of the durable consumption, but we're also now trying to look in together with manufacturers and how can we change this design to make it more durable or easier to repair.
Yeah, I can see that. So you've outlined some of the challenges, but are there any other challenges that need to be solved? And what would need to be done in terms of product design or the business models? How might they need to evolve?
Well, one of the opportunities with sort of redesigning these appliances can also be that you can redesign them in such a way that they nudge people into the right way of using them. Mm. For example, by in the case of a washing machine, automatically turning it to a 30-degree program, which you only can manually then turn to a 60 or 90-degree program. So steering people into using it in the right direction. Mm. But when it comes to service models, there is a critical thing that is hard for companies like us to solve, and that is the financing. Mm. As you can imagine, in the old school way where people just buy the machine outright, the OEM, the producer, the manufacturer, he receives the money straight up. Mm. But we, as a service provider, only get little chunks of money over a period of time, whilst we still have to buy all these appliances ourselves at the beginning. Mm. So we need to sort out a way in order to actually bring in enough cash for us in beforehand to actually buy and own these machines, place them with the consumer, and then slowly get that money back over the course of the service period. And that, I think, is the biggest challenge to solve in order for any service model, including pay-per-use, to work.
That's excellent. Thank you very much.